This is me. This is the calm before the storm. This is me relaxed. And then me on stage is me accelerated.
This is mad Hollywood right here. This is like Hollywood times two, you know? You might walk in here and see like Jerry Seinfeld just having lunch with, you know, the ghost of Bob Hope. You never know.
Now tell me this, what are we talking about?
The producer of the show brings the energy to it. And I don't really want the power as in like, oh, look at me, I can book the show. But you all of a sudden get people who are asking to be on shows and you realize, wow, I have this power of crushing people's dreams.
I think I was always a comedian. It's just that I didn't start to get paid for it until like 2 weeks ago.
2003, I quit my job and I said, this is what I want to do. I make comedy my sole focus. And, you know, I made it on Adam Richmond's show.
Here's the thing, LA peeps. Really crazy, a lot of people in the entertainment industry, obviously. And everyone's pitching shows. So I've came up with a new idea for a reality show. I'll run it by you. Here's the reality show. We get architects from all over the world. We stick them in a house, and their one goal for the entire television series is to design a Trader Joe's parking lot that works. That's it. That's the entire reality show. Build a fucking parking lot that doesn't make me want to shoot myself. Anybody have crazy anxiety when they basically I just pull into the Trader Joe's parking lot? I'm like, no, I can't. There's no room. And then I go to Ralph's. That's what I do.
My audience is just energy, great energy, and they're smart, you know, none of the stuff, the stupid fart jokes and Schwarzenegger jokes, intelligent audiences, that's what we like, and you can't always rely on that on the road or anywhere else in the city, but I can kind of guarantee that on a night like this.
So I grab the condom, I open it up, I go to put it on, and she's like, just do it, Dan, just do it. So I go to do it, and here's where the honesty part comes in, all right, because we've known each other for moments. I go to put it in, and I finished fastest in the history of penis. Yeah, I don't care who you are, I don't care what story you've heard. Hi, this guy. I finished the fastest in the history. I finished so fast, when I was done, the bottom half of my penis was still a virgin. Do you have any idea how fast that is? The top half of my penis was making fun of the bottom half of my penis. He was like, you don't get none. He was like, I was right there!
I try to turn painful stories from my past into jokes so that strangers can laugh at me. Because that's the ultimate... Really, that's what being insecure is all about. Letting strangers laugh at you for no good reason.
You can see him on Comedy Central. He just got back from New York City to a one-man show off Broadway, which is amazing. Please welcome Don Reeves.
Check this out. There was a guy walking into a nightclub who thinks he's cool in slow motion.
You and your father is a dentist, your father is a pimp. But yet, we meet in the field of stand-up and couldn't get along though. Am I right?
Yeah.
And that's about art. You know, they don't mean to be cheesy, but that's when the artists see each other and we relate based on what we're doing on stage, you know, how much fun we're having.
Good light, positive all the time.
Yeah, well, you are he's the most positive guy ever. So I want to thank you on Facebook for being a good man and a good influence.
Absolutely.
And a good spirit man, Don Reed.
We'll see you guys again, right? Yeah. Let's check him out.
Come on!
he loves comedy, he loves performing. We're similar in the fact that it's all about commitment. We commit to the show, and there's a lot of comedians that never laugh at jokes, but I don't know, I think the only thing that separates Adam and I from the audience is the stage. You know, a good show is a good show.
I like when athletes celebrate guys at home run, a three-pointer, a touchdown, they always do this. Like they point to the heavens like God has something to do with it. I wish we could do that in regular life, have like a normal job, be like a lawyer, we find our client not guilty. Maybe you work for FedEx, oh my God, I got the packages, I'm done. Maybe after sex with a loved one, like, honey, that was awesome.
And the way he ties it in the end, that was crazy. I'm like, Robbie, you did that out. I was like, that's killer. Interlocked like five punchlines into one chunk in the end.
I just like being challenged, bro, as you guys know, right? You guys like it? I like being challenged by the ladies. I was like, you cannot handle this. You cannot. It's always yapping. By the way, only date black women. That's what I say, listen, ladies, I've been indulging in a healthy portion of pussy ever since I've been tall enough to look one in the eye. So at some point, just figure out what you're doing down there. Sometimes the ladies use the argument, well, I have a pussy, so I know it feels better. Well, guess what? I have a dick. That doesn't mean I give a better blowjob. In fact, if ever I had to give a blowjob, it would be something like this.
Doing comedy is like a muscle. I mean, you have to keep practicing, you have to keep doing it. And if you don't, you lose the ability.
Let me tell you how cool this club is, right? Adam calls me up and goes, Claude, do you want to come up here and do the show? I said, yeah. Hell yeah. I got rules, though. I got rules. Rule number one, the front row, I need a table, three hot chicks, one black, one white, one Jewish with big tits. Bam! Rule number two, I need a black man with sunglasses and maybe blind, but definitely fucking high. Boom! In front of him, I need a guy sitting in the douchebag section that looks like a cross between Gargamel from the Smurfs and Richard Grieco. Thank you, sir. Gargamel Grieco.
There's a psychology to comedy that I never realized till I started doing it, you know? Like even tonight, I mean, I knew I had to go up there, I had to get their attention right off the bat. If I didn't, they would, I mean, even two girls were texting and I had to make fun of them, you know what I mean?
A lot of diversity here at the Improv. I don't mean like color and religion, I mean like height. There's always a lot of different heights of people here, and I like that. The Laugh Factory sucks, it's all tall people.
I like horrible songs. Like that's like, I kissed a girl, and it's in my head all the, but that's because it's two girls making out, that's hot. Like if these girls started going at, we'd all be fucking stoked, you know? That song wouldn't work for dudes. You know, here I blew some dude, and it was yummy. Now there's come my tummy, you know.
Not really into religion though. It's a guy that's like, if you watch porn, you're going to hell. If I watch porn, I'm going to the bathroom, okay? I masturbate a lot. I went to a sperm bank and sold my blanket. Thank you. Just got back from the coke break, huh, chicks?
The audience is weird sometimes, but I think it's just all about you controlling them, not them controlling you, you know what I mean? Like, you wear the clothes, you know, and the clothes don't wear you, you know what I mean? So it's that kind of thing with the audience. So you just try to make some adjustments, you know. If there's an elephant in the room, acknowledge it, and then, but that would be kind of weird if there was an elephant in the room, but anyway.
How many people in here trying to lose weight? Anybody need to lose weight, trying to lose weight, think, oh, it's just two of us in this bitch? Really? That's it? That's okay. I can see you motherfuckers. The lights are hot. What are you? But don't you hate when you're trying to lose weight and all your friends become food police? You know, anytime you reach for food, I thought you was trying to lose weight. I thought you was... You trying to lose weight, aren't you? I thought you was... Any food, you know, then they know the calorie content. Ooh, that's got a lot. That's like 800 calories right there. Are you trying to lose weight? What are you doing right there? I'm in church trying to get communion. I thought you was trying to... You was trying to lose some weight. Then they always take you places you're not supposed to go. Like my friend took me to Fat Burger. You know, you don't take a recovering fatty to Fat Burger. I'm a relapse in here. It's like going to a club. I'm like, oh shit, is that my jam bacon sizzling right now? Jimmy, what's up, girl?
I think comedy gets a bad rap because people come to, they think that you go to a comedy show and people are going to talk about you. You know, they think, oh, I don't want to go. They don't really get that. It really is an art form, you know? It's entertainment. It's, I'm going to say again, an art form, you know, like playing the violin or the piano. But it just doesn't get the same kind of respect. And it should.